splendid late March Sunday in Boston in the Northeast. Our NCAA Road to the Final Four makes a stop at the Fleet Center in downtown Boston. A much anticipated matchup between the seven-seeded Indiana Hoosiers and the second-seeded Pittsburgh Panthers playing in the Midwest. Already Marquette outlasted Missouri in a thrilling game yesterday. They have earned a spot in the Sweet 16. They'll take on either or Indiana or Pittsburgh. Good afternoon, everybody. Vern Lundquist along with Bill Raftery. Bill, this Pitt story, quite a story over the last 2 years.
And to find out the rest of the story, they have to turn to Page. Julius Page, a terrific performer in, out, can soar with the best of them. And then you go to Coverdale on the other side. Indiana, feisty, gritty. They play small. The toughest guy is Coverdale.
This Indiana team came from 11 down to defeat Alabama in their first round game. Here are the starting lineups. It's Newton, Leach, Coverdale, Bracey Wright, and Marshall Strickland. For the Hoosiers, Jerron Brown, Ontario Lett, Donatas Zavatskas, Brandon Knight, and Julius Page for Pitt. The officiating crew before this sellout crowd, Larry Rose, Bill Gracie, and Scott Thornley. And Indiana and Pitt meeting for the first time since December 26, 1941. When we were puppies.
And I saw the game. Vern Lundquist.
Indiana goes. Wait a minute. Zavatskas has it. Gets it in the hands of Jerron Brown. Ontario left, and Zavatskas here's Julius Page. That ball tipped by Bracey Wright out of bounds. It will be Pitts to inbound.
I'll tell you, tough matchup out of the gate. Tom Coverdale on Jerron Brown. Just a tough competitor, Brown. He's very good around the glass, and he can elevate the lane and get jumpers over Coverdale.
And they're going to put Bracey Wright on Brandon Knight. Here's Knight off the dribble, up and under. Page.
Tell you what, no help defensively there. Absent.
Now Marshall Strickland. Here's Jeff Newton. Spin move. Zavatskas there.
And they get led, I think, on the baseline, Vern. Page is on Coverdale. When Coverdale moves to the point, we'll see what Ben Howland does. He may put Knight on him. That is a very tough matchup, I think.
Ben Howland, in his fourth season as the head coach at Pittsburgh, 3-1 in the NCAAs. They advanced to the round of 16 a year ago before losing to Kent State. But back-to-back marvelous seasons for this Pittsburgh team.
And Indiana on a roller coaster all year. Interesting team as they, at the end of the season, got organized, played well going down the stretch, and then lost to Penn State away for the Big Ten tournament.
Hoosiers had that great start back in November, December, ran into some bumps. At one point, they lost 5 in a row in Big Ten play, and then came into the Big Ten tournament, as Bill said, losing to Penn State. Played very well. And they come from behind victory here against Alabama the other night.
They share the nice pump fake by Lett and great help from the rear by Leach. I thought that was a clean play. Maybe underneath there was a hit. But he's deceptive with the foot speed, Vern. He doesn't look like he's a guy that's going to blow by you, but just a good little pump fake gets the guy to bite a little bit. Leach loves to block shots, and that's not a good defensive play by a shot blocker away from the goal. Let him come to you, big fella.
Ontario Lett first at the line for Pittsburgh. This, as has been well documented throughout the year, not a good free throw shooting team. Over the course of this season, they averaged 63%.
You remember the conversation yesterday with Brandon Knight?
Right. Talked
about he said, well, we've got to address it. We don't shoot them as well as we would like, but he felt better down the stretch they have become.
No, not that trip. There's Lett, tries to knock it away from Leach. Ball on the floor, Lett. He's got it.
Oh, he hits his own guy.
Play and knocked Julius Page backward.
Oh, there. Get a piece of everybody, Ontario.
2-2 ball game. Now here is Brandon Knight, picked up by Strickland. And Bracey Wright stays on Page.
Nice back up by Donatas here. He may have walked up. Great look, but the defense responded there. Strickland very alert
on the baseline.
That's the first turnover for Pitt. They come in with a 27-4 record. blasted Wagner in the most lopsided first-round game we had here on Friday night. The Seahawks and Wagner in their first NCAA tournament. Here's George Leach. You think he's got to have a big game.
He has to step up. Now, that's the left hand. When they take that away, he's got to devise something with the right, because they understand he favors that right shoulder with the left foot. Little kiss by the big guy.
George Leach at 6'11", fouled out of the game the other night. Very ineffective.
A nice switch here by Newton. Tough matchup on Page.
And he's off the front rim. Gracie Wright has it for Indiana. Gets it in the hands of Tom Coverdale.
And Tom's got to play within himself. He's got one of the great defenders on him, and Julius Page here on the wing.
Page is the best of the on-ball defenders for the Pittsburgh Panthers.
And the second one is Brown.
Right.
Plays a lot more team defense, according to Ben. He's on right.
Now here's Leach once again in the low post. Tries to muscle back in on Ontario left.
Goodness, don't do too much. I thought he made a double dribble. I guess they jarred it loose on him. But good defense. They let no double. They stayed at home on the wing. People, he had nobody to kick it to.
And Bill, this is such a physical Pittsburgh team. I mean, you've got such great strength down low.
It reminds you a little bit of the Pittsburgh Steelers philosophy.
Right.
They are not mean and lean. They got a lot of beef. And let me the beefiest right here.
Zabotskis, Ontario left. It's up and under. Doesn't get the roll, and it's cleared off by Jeff Newton. Here's Coverdale. Nice cut. The pass back to Leach. Not there.
Nice find. Got a finish. And Lett with a nice step in, too. May have jarred him.
4-2 ball game in the early going.
Knight's very good at letting the game come to him. Pretty good penetration, huh? A left all the way. He's got deceptive speed, man. He just coasts around and boom. Bangs by you.
Brandon Knight, two knee injuries this year, two ankle injuries this year. Reminded us yesterday, there was a shoulder problem as well. Foul on Julius Page.
The ability to use your left hand, so important to get a nice screen, right? The ability to turn the corner with your left. This is why he's so good. Coasting. Now the blow by. And the ability to get to the rim, so important. And they lift people so there isn't the inside help.
Von Troutman has come on now for Ontario left, wearing number two. Loose ball taken by Jerron Brown. Brandon Knight comes left side, Julius Page.
And the reach in by Coverdale. You mentioned Troutman in the game. He ran right to the rim, anticipating either a shape up or the shot. Terrific talent, one of the great sixth men in the country, I think.
He was bothered by an ankle injury and missed a couple of games late season, but will be a starter next year, Ben Howland says. And here's Julius Page, 70% free throw shooter for this season.
He's the highlight film on this team. Great in the open floor. They lob to him on occasion. And as you noted, defensively, par excellence.
Averages 12 for the year, a remarkable statistic for this Pittsburgh team. Six players in double figures for the season, and none scoring more than 12.
And Krauser is a guy that can get doubles different
right.
evenings and has a backup point guard, and they have a night, and he played together on occasion.
In their first round win the other night, they had six in double figures and one with 9 points.
Nice show by Zabakis.
Marshall Strickland, here's Coverdale. Finds Leach, got it. That's two baskets for George Leach in the early going.
They did a nice job defensively on the show by Zabotskis, and then they didn't cover to get back in position.
Now here's Brandon Knight. 6-6 ball game. We played 4.5.
They're not taking advantage of Jerron Brown. Looks like they're trying to set him up in the post area.
Here's Zabotskis. Back to Knight.
Always get it back to him. He'll take bad shots. Always in position. Under 10.
Knight, Strickland, Zabotskis. Goes by Newton. Little runner. No. Follow. Jerron Brown got it.
And that's a tough match for Coverdale. He is not that size. He's not comfortable down in the box area defensively. And Jerron Brown has a couple extra inches in that wingspan.
Well, Ontario Lett gets a brief rest on the bench. And a reach-in foul is going to be called on Brandon Knight.
Sets this guy up beautifully, though. Really gets good footwork. And then the great hands.
Well played. First 4.5 minutes. We'll be right back.
So many Cinderellas, and yet just one slipper. Poet. Is that a co-ed school?
Oh, the Huskies, the big bone team.
Hey, Craig, nice show tonight.
Hey, Billy. Feel free. I was just letting it breathe.
What's going on?
Just the answer to everything.
Introducing the Saturn Ion. Specifically designed and engineered for whatever's next. Get a 2003 Saturn Ion L Series or View at 0% APR financing for 5 years. For restrictions, see your retailer.
When I get older, losing my hair many years from now, will you still be sending me a Valentine? Birthday greetings, bottle of wine. If it'd been out till 2:45, would you lock the door? Will you still need me? Will you still feed me when I'm 64?
It's far better to spend 15 seconds looking at this now than in 15 years wishing you had. Retirement. Loans. Insurance. AIG. We know money.
Why do we rent from Enterprise? Because having the right car makes all the difference.
Grandma, look, they're here. Hi, Grandma.
Pick Enterprise. We'll pick you up.
Ladies and Kilborn, they're the best.
This is good.
Catch the boat on CBS.
Yeah.
Back at the Fleet Center in Boston, let's spend a quick moment with our colleague, Leslie Bissell.
Hey, Vern, you heard Bill say that they are so physical, so tough, that Pitt is almost like a Pittsburgh Steelers. Well, they are almost like a new steel curtain. They are so tough that Ben says, hey, we have to officiate practice. Vern, I think it's fitting that our buddy Mike Ditka also played basketball at Pitt.
I can't imagine that, you know.
He didn't need a helmet either, I'm sure. The referee during practice is Barry Worship, incidentally, the assistant coach, and they all abuse him.
Where did they film this? They said he's the worst official. Just don't think they foul any time, much less in practice.
Now Barry Worship and Jamie Dixon, the two chief assistants, along with Ernie Ziegler. Name is Slice. And there's Leach, little garbage. Didn't expect it, didn't make the basket. And Marshall Strickland has it, a reset for Indiana.
A night played Leach, how smart is he? Let's see what they got going here. He organizes the defense, gets back on his man Strickland.
Now Bracy Wright. Bracy Wright scoreless in the first half in the Alabama game of 17 in the comeback. And he also heard some things at halftime from his coach Mike Davis.
The first good look the perimeter people have had that time. Bracy Wright with the ability to pump them. Chris, airborne, you are in trouble.
Tied at 8. Good slip to the goal by Troutman.
What a find by night.
By day.
By night.
One if.
It's an historical town.
Yeah, it's an appropriate place to make that comment. 10-8. And Bracy Wright tries to get the English. Not there. Rebound. Here comes Brandon Knight from Pittsburgh. They lead by 2.
Wonderful control. But look at this alley-oop. What a read. With composure. He's got something in mind. He's got the great side eyeballs to find and deliver.
And the minute he saw Julius Page begin the break, the ball was in the air.
It'd be great timing. You know they've worked on it frequently.
Page has 6. Indiana gets 2 from Marshall Strickland.
Well, his improvement has enabled them to put Coverdale off the basketball. It's toughened up this team. Davis imploring there on the sideline, by the way. He's not happy with the D early.
Now Brandon Knight for the pick and roll with Javon Troutman.
And he might take advantage of Troutman down there.
Here's Brandon Knight. The penetration and the kick out and a 3-second violation.
Well, you love your point guard to be unselfish, but also to have a great head. Here's the alley-oop. And they didn't even need the screen. It was unnecessary. The great find. He just now, the banging in the lane sets that up. Notice Ontario Lett steps up, drags the defense. Knight sees it all and makes the great decision.
Coverdale at the point. A.J. Moyer has come off the bench wearing number 2. There's Coverdale trying to establish position, and A.J. Moyer with his first touch of the game. Little curl from Coverdale, and put back is good.
Newton, how about that, huh? Right at the rim. Playing small now. Let's see who wins this battle. Indiana's gone small. Let's see if they can take advantage, Pitt, with their size.
Well, Kyle Hornsby has come in as well, so essentially 4 guards. Look at this.
Carl Krauser goes right by Hornsby, gets the basket, shoots a free throw.
I got to find out what that crossed arms are. Yeah. You know, every time he does something excellent, and he does it a lot, he crosses the arms. This is a lift of the backside. Nobody down here. You can see everybody's head on the ball. Coverdale concerned about where his guy is going, and then the ability to blow by and finish for 3 here.
Carl Krauser, who earned a huge reputation in the playground in New York City, made his way through a number of high schools in that city, I might add, and spent a year getting academically qualified and sat out last year. Has really contributed for Pittsburgh this year.
Nice use of the curl for cover there. He's not getting many opportunities. Page, a little late. You got to hug his hip. You know, you're turning away from the defender. Coverdale can sneak a peek at him and then knock it down.
Hoosiers have a lead on Tom Coverdale's 3.
But finishing the project, so his education continues with Knight. Knight's really taught him a lot about the pace of a game.
Julius Page in and out. Bracy Wright, 3-on-3. So Bracy Wright will get it in the hands of Coverdale. They'll go with a set. Ben Howland telling us, Bill, that he saw them run 80 different sets in scouting this Indiana team the other night.
Nice post pass here, and a kick back by Coverdale.
Newton, 3, not there. Krauser. And Hornsby comes from behind, can't quite get it.
Bernie, you mentioned those sets, but you have to do the fight. You can't go through those in one day. You have to rely on your principles defensively. How you handle screens, cuts, anybody that's making any sort of a maneuver with the dribble, where you shade.
Let the free throws.
That's what they have to do. Pound it. They've got the beef. Take advantage of it. The understanding of how to turn away from the defense set here. Now, as he turns in, you can see Page is late. Now, you've got to slip the screen, or you've got a hand on his hip. Either way, but you can't give that distance to a guy who can knock and convert shots down with great consistency.
Let's see how Ontario Lett fares at the free throw line, a second trip. One more. He is 1 for 3.
Now, Vern, I know you remember this story as we look at Ontario. The long arms. Jimmy Dixon went to see him play in an AAU game. He was 6'5". He said, would you raise your arms? He put his arms up. He was like a 6'9 player. He said, would you like to come to Pitt?
Ontario Lett had played at Pensacola Junior College, so in his second season. And a really irrepressible personality.
And the only time they've seen him there was at the Big East game. They said, he always smiled.
He cleaned a few cups of water off the table. Knight with a steal. Great read. Boy, what anticipation by Brandon Knight. There is Newton. There's the pass to Lett and 2.
And look at the punch in the air by Knight. I mean, that's what you want from your point guard. Get everybody involved. They don't care who scores. This is all about winning. Ben Howland has gotten his team to understand. Get the right guy, the basketball. I mean, it's just a terrific read. The understanding of dumping it in there and the finish by Len. He really seals off, too. Look at the size of him.
You know what? That was a heck of a catch, too.
Wonderful eye-hand coordination. You're right.
Bet. And here's Ontario Lett for the old-fashioned three-point play. 3-point Pittsburgh lead, 10:28 remaining, first half.
He has his 3 guards in there now. Down to 14 seconds.
Oh, almost stolen by Drexler. Boy, is he good at
that. Got a drive to the basket. It's down to 7 seconds.
You can see the time. Wittenberg, oh, that's a long ways.
Have you ever see more motion.
When athletes sweat, they lose more than just water. Gatorade puts back sodium and potassium, proven to replenish and rehydrate athletes better than water. Gatorade, is it in you?
Let's say this is you, and this is your auto insurance company. You've always gotten along okay, but let's say this is Allstate. Ooh, looks better than what you got now, huh? Well, qualified drivers who call Allstate for a free auto quote can get a company this good for this kind of price. Maybe less. The choice is pretty simple, don't you think? So call Allstate now for an auto quote and find out how you're in good hands with Allstate.
The Home Depot is more than a store. It's a showroom for the newest riding mowers from John Deere. And now it's no payments or interest till January 2004 when you make any John Deere tractor purchase of $299 or more with your Home Depot consumer credit card. We've done our yard work homework and have the know-how to find the John Deere for you. We have everything you need to turn your yard and your neighbors a healthy shade of green. The Home Depot. You can do it. We can help.
March Madness is in the air. And this family has got the fever.
Now who's with me?
Don't miss Still Standing CBS Monday after Everybody Loves Raymond.
Pittsburgh leads it by 3, 19-16. CBSSportsLine.com, keyword to CBS Sportsline. Follow every play from each game of the NCAA tournament. Mike Davis in his third season as the Indiana head coach. And a 6-2 record in the tournament.
The best coaching job he ever did was at halftime 2 days ago.
They were down 11.
Unbelievable comeback, I thought. Of attitude, too.
Right.
It wasn't just the points. I mean, you could just see the spirit. He was saying that to both of us, he didn't know if Bracy Wright would speak to him after that game. And Bracy performed admirably, as did Tom Coverdale, who's getting a little blow right now. They came out ready to go.
Marshall Strickland back on. Here's Hornsby from the corner. Looks good, is good.
And you know, that's twice now Julius Page has been targeting, trailing the jump shooter. Nice screen set to get Hornsby a good look.
14 points in the paint and 5 free throws. So they've been pounding it inside.
They got the zone look now, so that the middle looks wide open. Now they go back to man.
Now Brandon Knight, Carl Krauser, Zavatskis, Troutman, and Page on the floor for Pittsburgh.
Look at his post up and close.
Oh, dear.
Tell you what, though, Vern, that's too easy. They're not a good denial, and that body, he gets the dirty air, cups you, and just leans to the goal. Should have converted the first, though.
21-19, under 10 to go, first half of play.
Krauser now on Hornsby, and now Page has got right.
Strickland comes back outside. And Leach pops out for the high pick and roll.
See how they zone in the back trap, the automatic switch.
Right.
Vodka shows and stays.
Now Newton traveled.
Terrific defense, but on the offensive end, the understanding of getting it inside, they really do a good job. Now watch how he gets the ball on the baseline. That's the message. Just drop step to the lane. He ends up tipping this one in. But that's easy. You got to really fight the guy down there. But Troutman's larger than life on that box area.
21-19. Carl Krauser has the ball in his hands. Right. Trails him defensively. And Jerron Brown now with Hornsby. Too easy.
You know what's good about this running season? Brandon getting to the foul line early.
Mm-hmm.
You know, a lot of games, he might not get his first free throw until late in the game. This way, he can get a little feel. He gets a rhythm.
Now, Brandon Knight hitting just over 55% from the line, but he was well below 50 for much of the year, then had a late season surge, and with the exception of 5 unsuccessful visits to the line against Villanova, he is until then, been hitting pretty well. Here's the singular wireless fan poll. Which number one seed is most likely to be upset in this year's tournament? Arizona, Kentucky, Oklahoma, Texas. Singular wireless users send vote to 171 or log on to cbssportsline.com/singular. Stay tuned for the results for the singular at the half.
Well, the Zags gave it a run last night, huh? Solid. Mark Few and his guys were what a wonderful basketball game.
Yeah, that was.
Just great to watch. Tough one to lose, obviously.
Tough for us to root.
Oh,
huh?
Yeah, just what two wonderful people.
Yep.
High class programs.
Here's Hornsby, gets the pick from Leach, loses control, over and back.
Nice pressure defense. They're having trouble. You know, I get away from the pick and roll. They're bringing guys into a situation where they're having some difficulty.
Van Hallen is going to send Julius Page back on the floor and give Brandon Knight a rest.
And Vern, statistically speaking, Indiana, 41% is what they usually hold opponents to. And right now, 8 for 13 Pitt at 62%. So Indiana making some mistakes on this defensive end. They got to tighten it up.
Five turnovers now for the Hoosiers. Here's Zabotskis, looks inside. Troutman. Backs Newton, tries up and under. Good defense by Newton. Troutman aggressive to the ball, but went off his hand.
Newton, he just did a little get together. But you can see how the shoulders and the strength he possesses in that box area. Very tough to contain him once he gets it that deep.
Now, Ben Hallen thought his team was ready for this tournament the day before it began when Siobhan Troutman and Donatas Zabotskis had a little confrontation during the practice.
I think Zabotskis fights with his cornflakes. He's just one of those characters. He's got a wonderful sense of humor. Maybe not like Ontario Lett, but maybe he's the spark they need, the toughness defensively. That's what they're known for.
Dave Busnick's a peaceful man, but he's being sentenced to
anger management
on April 11th.
We've got 30 days to get your anger under control.
I don't think you should be moving in with me.
Keep an open mind.
I like to sleep in the nude.
Embrace your emotions.
I said over easy!
Now, why did I do that?
Because I refused to spoon with you last night.
And let the healing begin.
How do you feel?
Anger Management, rated PG-13, opens April 11th.
Advisors. Working with one can leave you better prepared. At Wachovia Securities, we learn from the world around us and provide financial advice for whatever comes your way. Together, we can achieve uncommon results. Wachovia Securities.
We are back in Boston tonight on 60 Minutes. Americans in uniform as soldiers, no, as cops, getting ready to do battle with terrorists tonight on 60 Minutes After Basketball. 22-19, well played first half, 7:54 to go. Both teams hitting around the 50% mark in the field.
Burn, here's the zone. They showed it for a few seconds earlier. And this should be a foul line sprint by either Page or Brown. Now, they've run some nice things against the zone. They screen in the center man and then get somebody to duck in.
There's the little give inside to Brown, but he shuffled his feet, Jerron Brown. He's been bothered by a hamstring.
That's the one guy that they're right. Not as concerned about the ankles for Troutman and Knight as they are. You're right. But he is a talent. But Leash is on you there. He stepped up. You got to slip the ball or something underneath. He's got to present themselves.
That was the third Pittsburgh turnover. Here's Coverdale. Had just a splendid all-around game the other night. 23 points, 8 rebounds, and 8 assists. Tom Coverdale, the senior.
And a great attitude.
Off the glass for Newton, doesn't get the fall. And Zabotskis has it in the hands of Carl Krauser. Here comes Pitt.
Now, we talked about learning the process you go through as a point guard. I would say early in the year, he made a dribble right down the lane, Krauser.
Left, little soft jumper. Coverdale with another rebound. Got to make those.
Yeah, you sure do. Point blank. Struggle, huh, Vern?
Yes.
Got to value the ball. Chris Newton got a great look the last trip. I mean, you can't argue. Here's the pick and roll. Let's see how they handle it. They stay at home.
Okay. And the entry pass to Leach. Well, they're getting what they need from him.
I think Ben is saying, all right, let's guard the perimeter pick and roll. Stay at home on it. Let Leach beat us. If he can continue this getting free, I'm surprised. Let him duck into that lane.
1 point Pitt lead. Krauser, nice dish. Ontario left goes down hard and got no ball.
Great quickness with the hands.
Right off the mark. Krauser, it's 2-on-1 if Left can get back. Coverdale does for Indiana. Krauser in the lane, no. Left, no. Here comes Tom Coverdale.
Okay, what a great job. Strickland checked out Left. I mean, he went right after his thighs.
Now the reset by the Hoosiers. Indiana, they came into the tournament a year ago with a 20-12 record as a 5 seed, made it to the Final Four. They came in this year as a 20-12, as a 7 seed, and they just turned it over.
Good show defensively. Now they do this a little bit late. Now they stay at home, but look at down in here. They were looking to zone in the back. That's why Let permitted Leash to get in the lane. I mean, they have been switching that particular play, but a nice counter by Indiana.
Zabotskis, good look.
That's a set play too for him. He'll screen in.
In and out, and Indiana with a chance to take the lead. 22-21.
Now, Brent, here's the show on the pick and roll. Everybody stays at home, but I think Zabotskis gambled just a little bit, but does get back in time to cause the problem.
And Jeff Newton not quite ready to receive that bounce pass.
Mm-hmm. Mike Davis must want to exploit the pick and roll. He had to see something in tape because they're continually doing it. He likes the way they're causing Pitt to switch or get that post up.
We're nearing 5 minutes. Zabotka's pass too hard and off the hands of Brandon Knight.
And he knows. A little harsh with that delivery.
And again, Indiana with a chance to reclaim the lead. Pittsburgh.
It was drab for both clubs.
Unexpectedly ineffective the last 7 times down.
Much better job by Page on that curl with Coverdale.
Now Newton will back Zabotskis in. Loses control of the ball again. And the foul is called on Donatas Zabotskis. Came here as a 17-year-old from Klaipėda, Lithuania. His mom still lives back in that little city, 20 minutes from the Baltic. Zabotskis will graduate with his degree and has learned to be quite expressive in English and Lithuanian.
And the referees understand every word of that. His mom, Rima, they send tapes.
Right.
She gets a chance to look at them.
She was never able to make it across the pond to see her son play a tip. And again, a point blank miss.
And he hustles and gets it. But you're right, they're getting great opportunities around the rim. But I think it's the size. Newton and Leash intimidating a little bit.
Ben Howland was talking about Zabotskis missing 3 from in close 2 days. days ago, we've seen Lett and Troutman miss today.
There's the string out, they get the mismatch.
Brown, that looks good.
I'll tell you what, he does look good. He's a terrific middle game player. Also can put it down, a 10-foot runner that he knocks.
25-21. The high pick and roll again.
And they exchange the people.
Strickland has it, rim out. Troutman, here's Brandon Knight for Pitt. They're up by four. Zabotskis. Brandon Knight with a jumper.
Got it. Patience. Zabotskis gave it right back to him. He knows he's going to make the right decision.
And you know well what he told us yesterday. He learned how to shoot a jump shot from your son, Billy Jr.
Well, he took enough shots. Billy, that is. He said he had to give the ball up to him. Nice penetration here. The defense again by Brown. But the understanding of this team, they've got great composure as they attack you. They don't do anything silly. Everybody in position to rebound if it is a miss, but the knockdown by Knight.
Introducing the fast new C230 sports sedan with a supercharged compressor engine. To catch one, you gotta be in one.
Like that. Sierra Mist. Taste one shockingly refreshing lemon lime.
I gotta get me a dog like that.
We're witnessing a college basketball miracle. Dick Vitale silent for an entire 17 seconds. It must be the crust, the juicy toppings on that delivery pizza.
For fresh baked pizza at home.
Play DiGiorno's Advance to the Dance. You could win a trip to the 2004 NCAA Men's Final Four, one of 70,000 prizes. Details on specially marked boxes.
How about this one, babe? We somehow find everybody who bought the CD last week in Chicago.
From the database.
Sweet.
When the band gets to Chicago, we contact all those fans.
Through the mail server.
Sweet.
Offer them a t-shirt, concert tickets, something.
From the online store.
Sweet. Sweet.
Now that, babe, would rock.
Sweet.
What are you rocking, babe?
Sweet.
.NET Connected Software helps you connect with customers. That's software for the agile business. From Microsoft.
Michelin designed the cross-terrain SUV tires specifically for SUVs to help provide responsive handling and a smooth ride. You'd be surprised just how smooth. Michelin, because so much is riding on your tires.
Hit by seven, they've hit 50% of their shots, and Indiana averaging only 11 turnovers per game.
And against Alabama, they had eight for the evening, so you can see what Pitt has done. Rattled them a little bit. They continue to run the pick and roll and get the switches that they want, and they've gotten good position, but both clubs not converting around the rim as they are known to do.
Julius Page is gonna walk this one up with Zabotskis, Knight, Troutman, and Jerron Brown on the floor.
Covered there with that Brown matchup. Nice denial. Didn't get a good angle, Knight.
Gracie Wright.
He got his hands on it, though.
Brandon Knight.
You're always bigger when you put those hands up. Running back, you never know. Makes it a tougher angle.
Now, we mentioned that Brandon saying he learned how to shoot a jump shot from Billy Raffer Jr. They were in prep school. Is that it?
No, it was grade school.
Grade school.
St. Joseph's in West Orange, and he's learned pretty well.
Billy taught him well.
Well, I don't know about that. He is really a gamer. And he was talking to us about his first game in the Big East. I think it was 44. Nice cut by Coverdale. I'll finish that in a moment. Look at this guy. Great defensively.
Great reactions.
Here comes Page, a 10-point margin.
The night was saying, I think it was 44-16 against St. John's, and they were vanquished. And he said, he's a freshman now. What is this going to be like this the rest of our career? Well, he turned it around. Well, that one was deep and maybe ill-advised.
Right.
But he's got a little run going.
Now, Brandon Knight in his fourth season, of course, his father, Mel, is on the staff with Bill Raftery at Seton Hall. You've known the family forever.
Now, he's just one of those special people. Great family. And Devin, of course, with the Grizzlies
after a stellar academic and athletic career at Stanford University. Here's from the corner, Strickland, not there. And Zabotskis with great position for the rebound.
See how under control, Turk? Not going to get many opportunities. Indiana's got to take advantage of them.
10-point Pittsburgh lead.
This is where Indiana has to toughen up to get back in it. Offense will take care of itself.
Nothing run. Troutman. There's Leach.
Steps. Good job by Leach.
Yep.
The reason they're missing underneath, George is, he wasn't faked out of his shoe, by the way. It just happened to slip off. But I think the reason they're missing around the rim is Leach and Newton. You jar the shot or you hurry it. And then smooth the delivery.
Indiana, nothing in the last 5.5. Here's Coverdale.
Well, they've taken away their strengths, which is the perimeter shooting. Wright and Coverdale not getting ample opportunities, and now it's Knight on Wright.
Here's Newton, loses it, and it goes into the hands of Troutman.
This is the Pitt team that we've watched all year, and you look at them and you say, are they that good? Yes, they are. They know how to guard you and get after you.
The chicken has got to be just so, and it comes out so golden brown and crunchy. Ooh.
Come on to my house, come on.
You got to have the combination, marinara sauce, the chicken, and the mozzarella. Just the right amount. Bellissima.
Back for a limited time, the Italian chicken sandwich at Burger King. Crispy all-white meat chicken, rich marinara sauce, and mozzarella cheese. Or have it your way and choose the original chicken sandwich, only at Burger King.
Come on to my house.
Introducing new body wash from Old Spice.
When I walk through a jam, no one knows who I am. Put my love to the test, and I miss the success.
It has a dual action formula, so you'll get really clean, smell really great.
Hey Ben, need help with your anatomy homework?
You!
New body wash from Old Spice. Spice things up.
I wanted to know.
I had H&R Block double-check last year's tax return. Free.
More than 500,000 people have taken the free double-check challenge at H&R Block. Those that overpaid got an average of $1,300 more.
They found over $2,000 my CPA missed.
I got $1,000.
It's my money.
I want it back.
It's your turn. See if we can help you get more back. Take the free H&R Block double-check challenge.
Point 1 seconds left. Will the dream die here for Duke? There's the pass to Leitner. Puts it up. Yes!
An incredible play.
Hit by 10, and Brandon Knight has helped get them to that spot.
Well, he just has a great feel. They slip well. Troutman this time gets to the rim. They both use it in the lane, set you up for the Page delivery. And how about that? You mentioned the catch on that particular play. He enjoys it. And by the way, Vern, 4 assists, 4 steals, and it all started right there. Mom and Dad, Brenda on the left, and of course, Mel. A real solid guy, too, as a teacher. He's taught him time and understanding game situations, and now he's improved as an offensive player. Just a great stat line, great leadership qualities, and I didn't know this. He told us yesterday he was either going to Penn or Princeton, and Chris Ralph Willard recruited him for Pitt, and that's where he ended up going, but now running out the clock, we're getting it close to the end.
And he wants to be a coach, and the guy who's guarding him right now wants to be a coach.
Both of them will be great coaches, I assure you.
Yep. Brandon Knight and Tom Coverdale, two of the best young men as examples of what this collegiate sport can be.
That was a kick out by Zabakas, and now the foul by Brown.
Clock stops with 4.7 to go.
And on the side, so he's not happy it was Brown giving the foul. I don't think he was giving it away, although it turns out okay, except he got the foul.
Indiana has called time. They trail by 10. We'll be right back.
Mr. Goodwrench, who is this one and only GM expert? I gotta find this guy.
You're Mr. Goodwrench.
Yep.
Which means you use genuine GM parts.
Oh, actually, we all do.
Now you're just trying to throw me. Mr. Goodwrench had over 1 million hours of GM training last year?
That's right.
Doesn't leave much time for Mrs. Goodwrench now, does it?
Find Mr. Goodwrench at over 7,000 GM dealerships nationwide.
If Mr. Goodwrench were a tool, what kind of tool would he be?
A wrench?
Ooh, sorry. Miter saw is what we were looking for. Miter saw.
We're just a few ticks away from singular at the half with Greg Gumbel and Clark Kellogg. All the tournament news. Billy Packer will join them for a tournament edition of Jump Ball. That's all coming up on Singular at the Half, 4.7 away.
They need some momentum, and now with right under the basket, some sort of a screen down to get an open jumper. You can catch and put it on the floor twice now with 4.7. They need a lift right now, Vern.
Kyle Hornsby will inbound. He tries to find Bracey Wright. There's Newton. And back to Hornsby. That was kind of a sloppy possession.
Yeah, and he couldn't get it. He looked right where he was going to pass it. You got to set the man up even when you're inbounding the basketball. But Pitt plays it to the end.
Well, Mike Davis's team trailed by 11 two nights ago to Alabama. He climbed in the pulpit and delivered quite a sermon. He's going to need something similar this time as the Hoosiers of Indiana trail by 10. Let's check in with Leslie Visser.
Vern, we know Pitt's defense is not false advertising. Ben, no Indiana field goals in the last 6 minutes. What are you emphasizing?
I didn't know that, but we always emphasize the defensive end of the floor first. That's how you're going to get a chance to win in big games like this. We made a couple big threes there. I think we had three in a row down the stretch and got us a lead. But we've got to come back out and play with that same intensity level at the defensive end where we're not in front of our bench in the second half.
What are you doing to them, to their perimeter, to cover down?
You know, we're just trying to play hard and doing the things that we do. I mean, this is a very good Indiana team who run so many sets. They're very hard to guard because they have so many different looks that they throw at you. And we had only one day to really try to get ready for this game. So we've got our hands full.
So far, so good. Thanks, Ben. Back to you, Vern.
All right, Leslie, thank you. The first half, 31-21. CBS Sports exclusive coverage of NCAA basketball will continue after this message and a word from your local station.
The fast new C230 sports sedan with a supercharged compressor engine. To catch one, you gotta be in one.
Roundup knocks out weeds in 24 hours. The leading imitator doesn't. Roundup Fast Act Foam knocks out weeds in 24 hours.
Think. Read. React. Struggle.
Succeed. Grow.
Every time we step on the floor, class is in session.
There are 360,000 NCAA student athletes.
And each one of us is getting two educations.
It's the NCAA tournament site with live scores, updated brackets, and insight from the top coaches. CBSSportsLine.com or AOL keyword CBS Sportsline.
Don't miss an all-new Survivor on a special night.
Somebody's going home.
CBS Wednesday.
the Lexus ES, now with special lease and financing rates available at your New York, New Jersey, Connecticut Lexus dealer.
Words, voice. Send them all with the new Panasonic photo phone and multimedia messaging, only from AT&T Wireless.
Ready to go?
Oh, yeah. Say it, shoot it, send it. The new photo phone from Panasonic. Ideas for life.
My mom always wanted to be a grandmother, but she died of lung cancer from smoking cigarettes just before my daughter was born. It was a slow and painful death. She was 51. She would have been so proud of her granddaughter. Emma would have learned so much from her. She looked so much like her now. I'll never forget what tobacco did to my family.
CBS Sports presents Singular at the Half. Singular's wireless polling allows you to get into the game.
Hi, everyone. Welcome back to our New York studios and a Singular at the Half. I'm Greg Gumbel, along with Clark Kellogg. And our score at the break, Indiana trailing Pittsburgh by 10, 31-21. Keep in mind, these Hoosiers trailed by 11 at halftime against Alabama just 2 days ago.
But they're turning the ball over, and Pittsburgh had a 9-0 run to end that half. Back-to-back-to-back three-pointers, and Brandon Knight playing extremely well. We'll take a look at Brandon Knight taking advantage of poor Indiana defense, just finding Chevy Troutman inside. The defender turned his back, and again, Brandon Knight recognizing Julius Page, knowing his personnel, recognizing the weakness and holes in the defense. That's what a good point guard does for you.
All right, Clark, earlier in our Singular fan poll, we asked which number one seed is most likely to be upset in this year's tournament. The results, no doubt, Arizona with a near miss last night leads the way at 38%. Keep watching for more Singular wireless fan poll questions. And a reminder that Pontiac and the NCAA are currently providing fans with the opportunity to pick their all-time favorite tournament plays by logging on to NCAAsports.com. Voting will continue throughout the tournament. It is now time for a March Madness edition of Jump Ball. My partner Clark Kellogg and Billy Packer from Nashville will give us their 20-second takes on the hottest tournament topics. Hello, Billy. First question is, give us your picks for the best team and individual performances of the tournament thus far. Clark?
I would start with Duke last night. I thought their defense and energy was terrific. And then Michigan State, I covered them a couple of times during the year, and they put together probably their best 40 minutes in their win against Colorado.
Billy?
Well, Kentucky is awful, awesome basketball team the way they're playing right now. But the team that probably impressed me with the game that they played so far was Notre Dame. I thought that they played an excellent basketball game on Mike Bray's 40th birthday yesterday.
Okay, I would like to also throw in a little point for Gonzaga, too, off of their performance last night. Number two, what's been the most surprising result in the tournament to date, Billy?
I think the fact that although the mid-majors are not going to be able to speak very highly of their one-loss record, I think the way they've performed, and you mentioned Gonzaga right there, the way they've performed in this tournament certainly shows that they belong, and I think that that has been tremendous. There have been some margins of victories that have surprised me, Kansas being one over Arizona State. I was really surprised at the way that they took them on.
A couple of situations. Purdue beating LSU wasn't that big a surprise. The margin of victory was huge. They won by 24, controlled that game really in the second half in a dominant fashion. And I also think Mississippi State being knocked off by Butler. We knew Butler was a very strong team, a good team. I thought Mississippi State would be able to control pace better than they did.
All right, guys. Top seed Arizona lost to UCLA in the opening round of the Pac-10 Conference Tournament. And they barely survived in double overtime against Gonzaga last night. Are the Wildcats vulnerable, and will they survive the West, Billy?
Well, you know, I think Al McGuire and Lute Olson have some kind of connect. One of the theories Al said is, you know, if he played in a postseason tournament, lose in the first round. Lute, listen to that. The other thing Al said, you only can win the national championship if you have a close game that you get by. Lute, you got to get away from Al. He's going to take you down the wrong path here.
Well, I certainly think Arizona has a great chance to get out of the West. The game yesterday was one of their better games, even though it was a double overtime close game. Remember, back in 97 when they won it all, they won their tournament games by an average margin of only 6 points per game, won the national championship in overtime. So I think they've got enough ingredients to still get it done, get out of the West, and win it all.
That old philosophy of whatever doesn't kill you make you stronger. Who do you see as a Cinderella team still alive in the tournament? Let's start with you, Clark.
It's a short answer for me. I don't think we have any Cinderellas. I think when it's all said and done, we're going to see teams that are somewhere on the top two or three lines as far as the seeding goes, and that's where your champion will come from.
Billy.
I'm going to say that on a national basis, I don't think people maybe gave Xavier the respect that they deserve. After watching them the other night, this is an explosive basketball team, very talented. I like the way that they play. And, of course, with David West, they've got Insato. They've got maybe the best 1-2 combination going in the NCAA tournament.
All right. This is an underhand lob for Billy. It's a chest-high fastball. Should the matchups for the Final Four be determined once the regional finals are over, Billy?
You know, I've been a proponent of this for a long time. I really think that the committee should seed the teams 1 through 64, let everybody know who's number 1 and who's number 64, and when you get to the Final Four, don't worry about the region. Play the number 1 team that gets there against the lowest seeded team that gets there, and then the two in the middle play. I think that would be a good way to have fairness for a good job done in the regular season.
You know, I wasn't in your camp a while ago. As recently as yesterday, Billy, I thought it was very good the way the committee set it up to go with tradition, let it play out the way it does. But since yesterday, I've changed my mind. I really think once you've seeded the field, you seed them for regions anyway at the beginning. Why not do it again at the Final Four? So I've joined your camp.
All right, Clark. Thank you. Billy,
well, you know,
thank
I'm
you.
Considered a wacko in many cases, but usually in time people come around. I appreciate that, Clark.
Not
no
always,
problem.
But usually. Thank you, guys. We thank you for watching Singular at the Half. Coming up next, Dan Rather has a CBS News special report, America at War.
CBS Sports presents Singular at the Half. Singular's wireless polling allows you to get into the game.
If you want to be voted an Automobile Magazine All-Star, you better be good. If you want a unanimous vote, you better be Mazda 6. Only Mazda 6, the car they said delivers high content of engineering and luxury features, got the thumbs up from all the judges. Oh, and these guys? No All-Stars here.
Yeah.
Lease an all-new Mazda 6i for $239 a month for 39 months with $2,539 due at lease signing.
Well, what have we got here?
In BASIC, everyone tells a different story.
What happened out there?
Wait, don't say it. I'll tell you.
But there's nothing more shocking.
I know who you are.
Than the truth.
They're dead, aren't they?
It's not like that.
It's not.
BASIC is a thrill ride with a twist you won't believe.
Woo-hoo.
Seductive and electrifying with non-stop action.
Am I scratching your surface yet?
John Travolta, Connie Nielsen, and Samuel L. Jackson.
What are you doing?
See what happens when you lie?
BASIC, rated R, opens everywhere Friday.
I swim the 200. I study sociology. I grind out laps. I cram for tests. I race nationals. I take finals. And when I finish, I'll be ready to start.
There are 360,000 NCAA student athletes, and thanks to continued support, Coca-Cola helps them pursue their dreams.
Let's take a look at the Coke highlights of the second round.
And he fires the three to win it. The rebound, the center, go down!
Walton backs in and scores a three with two. He shoots, and Arizona and Gonzaga will play another five-minute period. 1 second to go. Misses. Arizona is going to the sweet.
CBS Monday. It's the concert event of the season.
Hot potato. Hot.
Get ready for the Wiggles.
Like a mosh pit for three-year-olds.
Yes, dear. CBS Monday.
America at War, Dan Rather reporting. Facts indicate that overall the U.S.-led invasion of Iraq goes well from the Allied military perspective. American tanks are within 100 miles of Baghdad, deep inside Iraq. But the war is getting rougher. Some of the heaviest fighting around the town of Anasiriya. There are reports now of dozens of American casualties in that fight on the road to Baghdad. CBS News producer and reporter Phil Itner is with the Army's 3rd Infantry, and he reports on Marine casualties coming in.
A little after 5 o'clock in the evening, at this airfield shared by the Army and the Marines,
two Marine helicopters flew in. One of the helicopters was carrying an injured Marine. He was taken off by Army medical staff, given treatment, put back onto a medical Black Hawk helicopter, and flown onward. The other helicopter was full of Marine dead. At least 8 perhaps as many as 12. Details are sketchy where these casualties are coming from, but it does look as tonight the Marines have taken a hit.
British commandos also came under heavy fire in the south on the Afar Peninsula, as reported by Sky Television.
Well, British correspondent Clive Myrie has been with the Royal Marines at the Afar Peninsula, the strategically important port area on the Iraq-Kuwait border. He's just found these latest dramatic pictures of the successful mission to secure the area.
And those pictures, of course, green because they're seen through night sights. Colonel Mike Vickery, former tank commander, saw these pictures earlier too, indicating the sort of firepower needed just in these isolated incidents, Mike, to achieve objectives.
Yes, they're using their heavy machine guns there, but also their own personal automatic weapons firing onto a position there.
CBS News correspondent Lee Cowan went with Army Special Forces very deep into Iraq, very close to Baghdad. He's returned now to Kuwait and has filed this report.
Army Special Forces units are now operating close to the city center of Baghdad after being inserted deep behind enemy lines.
These are CBS News exclusive pictures of that operation at an Iraqi airfield seized over the last 24 hours. These special units will be the eyes and ears for the invading troops behind them, helping shape the battlefield with deadly precision. By dawn, they will be long gone, headed toward Baghdad, without leaving a trace they were ever here.
Thousands of Iraqis have been taken prisoner, the exact number not confirmed and unavailable. There are high casualties among the Iraqis, but again, no reliable figures yet available. Al Jazeera, one of the Arab networks, showed pictures today said to be American soldiers captured near Anasiriya. Five soldiers, one woman. Some of them said they were with a maintenance company. The U.S. confirms they are captives. On Face the Nation, Defense Secretary Rumsfeld told CBS's Bob Schieffer the Geneva Conventions prevent photographs that humiliate those captured. He also said that Basra, the major port of the Iraqis, has been subdued. He didn't say it had been captured. The British television network ITN confirms that one of their reporters, Terry Lloyd, is dead. He was, according to ITN, killed by friendly fire. CBS News national security correspondent David Martin now has an overview of the war from the Pentagon.
American forces continue their advance toward Baghdad, and as they do, according to Defense Secretary Rumsfeld, the Republican Guards units that are standing in their way are drawing back toward Baghdad as if they plan to fight from a fortress Baghdad. The American nightmare of having to engage in urban combat. And so far, Secretary of Defense Rumsfeld says he knows of no Republican Guards units that have surrendered. So this may be shaping up as a fight to the finish.
A Patriot missile fired from the Iraq-Kuwait border brought down a British jet fighter, the war's first confirmed incident of friendly fire. The wreckage has been found, no word yet on the fate of the crew. President Bush has returned to the White House from the early weekend at Camp David. Bill Plant is there.
Tomorrow, the president will finally unveil what he expects this war to cost. He has a meeting scheduled with the bipartisan congressional leadership, many of whom have been asking for some time when Mr. Bush is going to ask for money for the war and how much. The answer seems to be in the range of $80 billion. Most of that will be for the war, but some will be for humanitarian aid and for reconstruction efforts. Also, a slice for Homeland Security, with governors and mayors around the nation complaining that they don't have enough money for the extra security required by the war.
We'll continue to monitor events. When news breaks out, we'll break in. Dan Rather at CBS News World Headquarters in New York.
Cayenne, pure Porsche in a most unexpected form.
Papa John's presents a mouth-watering deal that'll put a smile on your face. Say cheese. Sticks. Free cheese sticks. When you buy a made-to-order large one-topping Papa John's pizza for just $9.99, John himself will toss in our delicious cheese sticks absolutely free. We start with Papa John's hand-tossed dough, garlic sauce, cheese made with 100% mozzarella, and two zesty sauces for dipping. Call your neighborhood Papa John's today and get free cheese sticks when you order a large one-topping pizza for only $9.99. We see you smiling.
Better ingredients.
Better pizza.
Papa John's.
I have to focus, gather everything I've learned, all my successes, all my sacrifices, all my pain, and concentrate that energy into one moment. That's a moment I'll use every single day of my life. There are 360,000 NCAA student athletes, and just about all of us will be going pro in something other than sports.
Don't miss Celine Dion in a spectacular live event. Celine in Las Vegas, CBS Tuesday.
The new BMW Z4 Roadster. The ultimate driving machine. For a limited time, lease the new BMW Z4 2.5i for $399 a month.
Listen, to grow, we need to know everything about our customers.
John, the Goldman sales call, they want you to do it tomorrow.
Okay, I'll need to know them inside out. How many locations since the mergers, subsidiaries we're in, globally. Look, this is make or break. Anyone?
It's all here. The D&B marketing data shows 80 locations. We're in 6 subsidiaries, 2 abroad.
Are you sure?
It's D&B, John.
Don't just be sure. Be D&B sure.
Ford SUVs. Go anywhere. Cross any terrain. On road or off. Now a special shipment has arrived for the best selection and the best deal. Now get a Ford Explorer 4x4 for only $299 a month. Just $299 a month. Ford, the best selection of the best-selling vehicles on the planet.
CBS Sports exclusive coverage of the Men's Basketball Championship is sponsored by Chevy Trucks. Okay. Capital One. Bacardi Silver 03. And by UPS.
Pittsburgh by 10 at the break, 31-21. Let's take a look at it statistically in the first 20 minutes of play, Bill.
And Vern, it's the field goals, field goal percentage, I should say, 46-38. Indiana really struggling, not getting a lot of looks. 3-point field goals, a wash. Ability to get it inside, vastly superior Pittsburgh in that category.
Marshall Strickland will start in the second half in place of, or rather, will sit in the second half. And Hornsby starts for Indiana, just as Mike Davis did in the game against Alabama two nights ago.
You were talking about the pulpit. I don't know if right. You can go there frequently, you know, with players. I think this was more a strategy, change the lineup. They went inside right away. Maybe you'll see a little more of that. But the difficulty is Gracie Wright not getting looks. Coverdale not getting looks. A real dilemma. Only 4 shots for both of them.
Here is Gracie Wright. He had only 2 points at the break the other night.
And Knight's defense turned it over.
And here's Brown. That's 11 turnovers. Zavatskis off the glass. And the lead is 13.
Wow. Unflappable, we were talking at halftime. This team going through the layups. So well oiled. Defensively, Knight creates the problem. And then the delay, the trailer by Zavatskis.
Indiana ended the first half 6-33 without a field goal. They went from 1 down to 10 down. And they start the same way here in the second stanza. So apparently no homily from Mike Davis at the break. Here's Zavatskis again, gets a pick from Ontario Left.
When somebody's playing great defense against you, it's very difficult to reach inside. And you got to find something that'll work. They got good shots the last 2 trips inside, but you saw Newton not converting, a dilemma.
Zavatskis for 3. Lent with a rebound. He loses it, and Gracie Wright picks it up for the Hoosiers.
Tell you what, he went up big time, though.
33-21. Pitt trying to climb back into the Sweet 16 for the second year in succession.
Now a little flare screen there away from the pick and roll. They had used that quite a bit the first half. Look at that, stepping into the passing lane by Knight. Pesky on the D.
There's a screen from Leach and a foul is called on Zabotskis.
Well, to run, you got a rebound or you've got to do a great job defensively. You can just see the trail here. Look at Zabotskis. Lets everybody know he's in the house. This unselfish team, they don't care who scores. It's all about putting wins together, and they've done it beautifully this year.
Now Zabotskis, one of the six who averages double figures, and he's right at it. He averages 10 per game, the senior from Lithuania.
Watch Lett inside there, just bodying his guy now. Forces him because he's so big and strong. 8 minutes. Well, you got to get something going. Maybe drive to rim, get to the free throw line. Good move.
Yep.
Leach, unleash.
George Leach has been their most effective offensive weapon in the game thus far. He's got 8 points.
Now, if you had your preference, who would you want to beat you if you're Pittsburgh? Is there, who are you going to force to beat
us? Chances and see if Mr. Leach could do it.
Yeah, exactly. And they're just teeing it up on the defensive end on the perimeter.
Coverdale, Wright, and Newton have been ineffective offensively. It's just been extraordinary. Well, take a look at this comparison. Tom Coverdale, 1 of 4. Bracey Wright, 1 of 4. Those are numbers from the first half.
And Coverdale averages about 10 shots a game, and Bracey Wright, 12 shots a game. Now, they need a good 10 each this half, at least to get back in this thing. But you can't take bad shots. They are covered. That's the dilemma.
And Julius Page stays on Coverdale, as he has been all game long. Here's Knight, goes to the steal. And that one is short, perhaps because Brandon Knight flashed in front. And now he gets the ball as Newton comes back and harasses him.
Consistently after you. I mean, that was just a great sequence. It's reminiscent of Bob Knight at Army.
That far back.
Unbelievable. I mean, they contested every pass. They picked you up coming out of the locker room.
Uh-huh.
Good play, heady play. Body search and get to the line. You mentioned Knight flashing into the screen. They hand hedge beautifully. They anticipate. We'll see right in here now. Just the right in here. Now, that's enough to, and then the step-up defense, that's just great. You cover for one another, and that's when you tell a team's personality. If they give up themselves on the defensive end, you've got a chance to do some damage.
And Brandon Knight at the free-throw line gets this, that one. He's 2 for 3 for the day. We were chatting about the free-throw problems yesterday, Bill and I, and he did improve dramatically toward the end of the season, with the exception of the game at Villanova when he went 0 for his last 5.
He told both of us, this is the most exciting thing that's happened.
Right.
Well, the Big East Championship, but now,
right,
looking forward to see how far they can go here.
Now, beating UConn for the Big East title, it was Pitt's first, and he said that's the best win he's ever had.
And look at the help here, traveling on one side. Knight came all the way across the lane. I mean, talk about leadership, the things you do. Ben asked him to come earlier. He did. Work harder. He did. And that's, I'm talking about a couple of years ago. And it's paid off. Everybody jumps on board. He doesn't have to say anything. It's all about what he does between the lines.
Coverdale asks for it. Doesn't get it. Here's Newton in the lane.
Good job.
Yes.
Kept the dribble alive. He can be tough because he can play his back to the basket, and he's got a jump shot as well, dribbling ability.
Larkin is not.
I'm just going to say, they're not playing well, and they're right there in the end. They're going to tighten it up this end, maybe get a run out off a mistake.
Page, jumper, got it.
Trailing all the way too defensively, and nobody stepped up.
Julius Page from Buffalo, New York, a junior. He averages 12 per game. And the margin of difference is back in double digits at 11. Leach.
Newton begging. See if they help.
They do. Knight comes at him, and Knight. Yep, they got Knight with a reach in.
Tell you what, that's what they got to go. Early in the half, they went down to Newton, and it was successful. He beat him with the dribble before. But right here, Troutman just doesn't get away from his man. And you're right, the little swipe in there. It may have been Troutman as well.
It was Troutman.
Yeah, he just, once your man catches the ball, Vern, you've got to give a little cushion. Because as an offensive player, if I know your body is on me, I know which direction to go. You're dictating to me which is the easiest path to the tip.
Yeah. Shefton gets the first. He'll shoot one more. Time has been called.
Okay, see how the trans side of the rails warm more than the other side?
Felt like a million. Felt like number one. Like a rock.
What are you handing down to your kids? Chevy, the most dependable, longest-lasting trucks on the road.
My wallet. My credit card was in it.
You did have a Capital One no-hassle card, right?
No.
Relax. Who's gonna find it out here?
Whether your card is lost or stolen, with a Capital One no-hassle card, you're not liable for a penny. Plus, you get the nation's lowest fixed rates.
What's in your wallet?
Introducing Intel Centrino Mobile Technology. The new wireless laptop technology designed to help you untangle, unburden, and unwire your life.
Morning, William. Like somebody got a haircut.
Was it too short? They're always glad
you came. Yeah. Hey, no, you can't drive the truck. See you tomorrow, Bobby.
And you come in and play.
Who can you count on? You know them by name.
Tiger Woods shoots for a feat never accomplished in the history of the Masters. Three consecutive green jackets. The Masters is on CBS.
Mike Davis did try another Gene Hackman Hoosier speech at halftime. His voice was actually hoarse. He told his team, you've got to take advantage inside. George Leach, one rebound, he said, that is not enough. He also told them they're going to have to do it themselves because, Vern, he told them Pittsburgh will not fatigue.
Well, I would agree with that.
You know, Vern, Elmer Gantry lives. If he could pull this off. This is, they get a little nickel dimer, I think, on Wright chasing Page. But I'm sure there were some X's and O's because of what they've done differently. They got totally away from that high pick and roll, which they ran quite a bit. Now they're into their free-flowing offenses. As noted by you earlier, they run so many things. Look at this alley-oop and catch. Ooh, that didn't convert. They lose attention, Pitt, once in a while. Now they will let you back in. Yep, up and under. Gracie Wright.
Wow.
And the margin is six. All of a sudden, the motion favoring the Hoosiers. A nice give by Coverdale, giving Wright plenty of time to make his own decision. The trail by Brown, and a chance for three right now. A pass to collection plates, but Mike Davis is in the house.
Well, Bracey Wright was the recipient of much of the sermon the other night because he had only those 2 points at the break. And look at this.
And you know, Troutman just a little bit off. He should have squeezed it, let it go. They take advantage, and they're right there down by four.
A 7-0 run. Now Coverdale looks into the eyes of Brandon Knight. Brandon Knight, the dish, the pump. And from the rear, it should be Hornsby. Tell you, the maturation process, Brandon Knight, just sensational, the calmness. But here's just terrific hustle. He's the free throw shooter, and all of a sudden there's some excitement on the sideline. They know they're in touch right now. And at the other end, Knight just takes over, seizes the opportunity, gets into the lane, puts it on a platter for Troutman, and the third personal foul on Kyle Hornsby. Third foul on Hornsby. Troutman 59% for the season from the free throw line. One more. Near the conclusion of every NCAA tournament game, we'll select a Chevrolet most valuable player of the game from each team. To date, Chevrolet has contributed more than $8 million to the general scholarship funds of America's colleges and universities.
You know, Don Nelson used to change your lineup for you. He'd be coaching the other team. If he was small, he would play big. You know, Brewer, McKeskey, remember those names?
Right, sure.
With the Bucks? Well, what he's done now, Mike Davis, is like Nelson, he's forced Ben to play smaller. They put Krauser in with Knight and Page on the floor at the same time. And a foul by Knight, a little reach in.
That's three fouls on Brandon Knight. So no foul problems for either team at the break. And all of a sudden, Hornsby has three and Knight has three.
Vernie's trying to get something started, and that was not a good play by him. They come in with Brown now.
Jerron Brown out, number four. Fourth team foul on Pittsburgh. Here's Coverdale, a quiet afternoon thus far.
And they are just all over.
Julius Page has been right with it.
He knows... Individually, if he can contain, it's a big help to this Pitt morale.
Newton, short. Into the hands of Troutman.
Good open look.
Now Carl Krauser, the freshman, the redshirt freshman, at the point.
And his poise will be tested. And he's got to run the show. We know he can beat his guy in the lane. He's spectacular going down the middle.
Everdale tries to fight through the wet screen. Here's Troutman on... On top,
they use all of the clock and generally get a good one. Very confident late in the shot clock. Down to 10.
Page guarded by Hornsby. Here's Troutman. Shot clock at 4. Good defensive set for Indiana. Page, tough shot. Oh. Out of bounds off Bracy Wright.
Tough break for Indiana. I mean, they were poised, stayed under control, and that switch out. A very tough delivery with Newton all over Page.
Yeah, even a smile from Mike Davis. Good defensive 35 seconds. And then the tap out. So a fresh clock for Pittsburgh.
Oh, don't gamble there. Too far. You turn, put pressure on other people and they get the bump there. Just a little overzealous.
That's three on Coverdale.
He's been around. He can wolf a little with the officials under control, but he wants to go over the top because Krauser's terrific with the bounce, can take advantage. That may have been one of those. He's going towards half court. Give it a slide under.
14 foul on Indiana. 13:45 to go. A 6-point game. It was 10 at the break.
But shortening the game right here.
Coverdale still with him. In the lane, Jerron Brown. Blocked by Leach. Here's Lett. Strong move. He'll shoot two.
And Jerron Brown really stayed with that, Vern. Very aggressive. And what's wonderful about Ontario Lett, first of all, he's got the body. It's almost like a Mack truck. He's so strong, he body searches, goes right at the defender to make sure he gets to the free throw line.
Now for a CBS News special report, let's go to Dan Rather in New York.
Dan Rather, CBS News, reporting with the latest on the war. With the U.S.-led invasion deep inside Iraq, U.S. tanks and ground troops are within 100 miles of Baghdad. President Bush returned to the White House from Camp David. The president said the war will still be a tough fight, but he said Saddam Hussein is in trouble.
I know that Saddam Hussein is losing control of his country. That we're slowly but surely achieving our objective. It's important for the American people to realize that this war has just begun, that it may seem like a long time because of all the action on TV, but in terms of the overall strategy, we're just in the beginning phases.
The president also demanded that the Americans captured by Iraq be treated humanely. This after the U.S. confirmed that 5 soldiers shown by Al Jazeera, the Arab network, and said to be American soldiers captured near Nasiriyah are indeed captives. One is a woman soldier. The International Red Cross says showing such pictures violates the Geneva Convention, the rules of war. As Allied troops advanced ever closer to Baghdad, casualties are mounting. on the Allied side and even more among the Iraqis. The U.S. Marine 1st Division and the Army's 3rd Division are nearing the key cities of Karbala and Al-Qut, south of Baghdad. Elite Iraqi Republican Guard troops are reported moving back toward the capital. U.S. troops fought a tough battle in Anasiriyah. Dozens of casualties now reported. Dan Rather, CBS News. When news breaks out, we'll break back in.
We welcome you back to Boston, where Pitt continues to lead. 39-32 score, 12:54 remaining in the ballgame. And an offensive foul just called on Jeff Newton. That is his second. Both teams now hitting 43%. Indiana hobbled by 12 turnovers and three-point field goals. Relatively ineffective at this point. Jerron Brown off the glass, fouled. He will go to the free throw line.
Nice call there, Vern. They had that clear out, able to hang and take the hit, almost kiss that one home. Taking advantage, the fourth foul on Hornsby. Good pressure dribble by Brown.
Jerron Brown at the line. Now Pittsburgh now 10 of 17. Live telecasts of NCAA men's tournament games are available now online and on demand over the internet. To find out more, go to CBSNCAAsports.com.
Moye into the game now, feisty performer too. See if he can shake it up a little bit for the Hoosiers.
And he is in because Kyle Hornsby just picked up his fourth foul. Hornsby, the senior from Anacostia, Louisiana, for the Indiana Hoosiers. Now here's Coverdale. One shot made in the game.
Amazing, isn't it? Guy they lean on. Here's a double. First time all game. Force others now to beat you.
Kick it back to Gracie Wright. How about the Jerron Brown defense?
Unbelievable. They make you use clock. Tough shots. And this is when the opportunity break. But if there's nothing there, they pull the plug. They use clock on both ends. They force you to run a lot of stuff and time on their offensive end.
Right out on Krauser. Under 12 to go. Here's Krauser going left in the lane. Too strong.
Look at the long arms.
There is Jerron Brown.
He can really seize opportunities. Bigger than he looks. Explosive around the rim, too.
8 points and six rebounds for the junior from Lexington, Kentucky.
Now you match up at the same size as Brown. The advantage is his nice slip to the goal, and Coverdale playing within himself with the fine to Leach.
Beautiful pass by Coverdale. Leach has 10 points. Pitt leads by 8. Again, Krauser just walking it up deliberately.
Just under control. Looks like their personality, understated.
Here's Krauser. Dish to left. Two more. Beauty.
A light night. They understand how to get into the lane and into the eight.
And among those leading the applause in an upright position on the bench, Donatas Zavatskis and Brandon Knight.
They know it's their last chance to dance.
In the corner, right, fade away, fouled, goes to the free throw line.
But well officiated game, too. That was a good call on that end. But Krauser and Brandon Knight spoke to both of us yesterday about learning how to play. And he feels Krauser has really established an understanding now to go with the great talent he possesses. Like he's dish at the end.
Gracie Wright, those of you who follow this Indiana team know the story of this young man's freshman year. Outstanding start. And a reoccurrence of a back injury cost him 4 games in the middle of the season, and he really is only at 75% to this point.
And Vern, they say he may have gone back to high school, that he's had that existing situation, and it does bother him, and he's going to have to play with it.
Comes from the Colony, about 25 minutes north of Flower Mound, just north of Farmer's Branch.
You can't tour a factory over a fax machine. You can't impress a client with just email. Not that I haven't tried. Sometimes they gotta see that winning smile.
Choice Hotels offers more than 2,500 locations across the country. Because staying close to your business can take you far from your office.
This smile remains undefeated.
Now when you stay at any Choice Hotel, you'll earn triple miles from participating airlines. Call 800-4-CHOICE. That's the power of being there.
Holy.
Let's say one phone company provides you long distance and a completely different one has your local service. Now, you probably pay too much for both of them, but you let it slide until you discover that with the neighborhood, you can get unlimited local and long distance together for one low monthly price. And just for good measure, extras like caller ID are included.
Get 50% off your first month in the neighborhood. Call 1-800-JOIN-MCI before May 1st. Over a million have joined.
How about you?
The new Silverado is here, now with quadrasteer four-wheel steering. It's the most maneuverable full-size pickup you can get. Silverado, the truck from Chevy.
Be a part of the madness when Craig Kilborn takes the Late Late Show to New Orleans starting Monday, March 31st on CBS.
Don't ask me what I had to do to get these beats.
Hit with a big edge in backcourt scoring, and they are up by eight. And Tom Coverdale being hounded by Julius Page today.
They've just played great team defense, but they assist the hand hedge. Page stays locked and glued. Here's the automatic switch with Knight. And you think you got an easy look. And this is such a tenacious, aggressive style of defense. You just don't get the opportunity. He's going to have to use screens a little bit and occasionally use the bounce. Otherwise, five shots.
Yes.
He needs half a dozen more, at least, to go in.
One basket for Tom Coverdale in the ballgame. 1 of 5. 44-36. And that has nothing to do with what he's doing. It has everything to do with what Julius Page is doing. Lett calls for the ball. Deep entry pass. Lett gets it from Troutman.
Why would he let the ball go in so easily to Troutman? This man didn't score, but it was his fault. Don't let a guy walk in the lane and beg for the ball that easily.
Back to a 10-point margin as we near the 10-minute mark. Pittsburgh leading Indiana. First game they played in 61 years. From the outside, got it. That's for three.
And Brown just a little negligent there. Didn't lock in, get the hand up quick enough.
Racing right, double digits. Up on the Indiana bench.
This is a big stop right here, Vaughn. Get the adrenaline, get the juices. Let's see if they're in the zone again.
In the zone, yes. 2-3.
Yeah, 2-3. The middle had been open like there, and then turn and find.
Troutman comes back outside. Now flashes back into the middle. There's the jumper, and it's good from Jerron Brown.
He's as good as anybody in the country with that shot. He sticks that southpaw in there, gets to the gap, gets to the lane, and bad news, Knight coming back in soon, too, to run the show or play alongside Krauser.
Now, Brandon Knight had a considerable rest here with foul trouble in the second half. Jerron Brown right in the face of Bracey Wright.
With a hand hedge of an Indiana slip, the guard helped down on the post area. This is a well-oiled defensive team.
There's Lett back to help on Newton.
Well, why would you foul? Force him into a tough shot. Just one of those exasperating things by the defense of your coaching. Saying go straight up. What a job he has done in the Steel City.
Ben Howland, son of a retired Presbyterian minister who lives in Santa Barbara, went to Cerritos College, played at Weber State, an assistant at Gonzaga, team that played so well last week when he was at Gonzaga. During practice sessions, he guarded a guy named John Stockton.
That's why he decided to become a coach.
Yeah, that's smoke on the ankles. And
he turned a few on him. By the way, you have a lot in common.
Well, I'm the son of a preacher, man. My dad has passed away 3 years ago as a Lutheran minister.
And you took the vow of poverty. And you've kept it all these weeks I'm working with you.
Oh, well, short arm is one of my nicknames.
Right now, they need some long arms at Indiana defensively. See if they can create some offense. They have not been able to get a run out. Just solid approach and the philosophy by Pitt.
48-41. Here's Brandon Knight guarded by Coverdale again. Left on the ground.
Nice.
Boy, that was terrific. And then the finish not there. But he gets the offensive board. Newton may have been around the neck.
They got a jump ball. Oh, he was out of bounds. I'll tell you what, Led is doing some moves. A lot of lingerie on the deck with his pump fakes and step through. He is a little bit exasperated by his inability to convert. He did everything right. Just keep hanging.
Siobhan Troutman.
Clear.
Moyer.
And the defense, Leach came over to help out, but I didn't hear anybody say open side or a lot of things. Is you got to help your partner. Then he shades to the dribble side, forces Brown to the middle. Moyer with his third.
And always worth keeping track of team free throws for Pittsburgh. As a team, 63% for the day. They are 11 of 18. And Ron Brown, among those under 70%, he hits 68% for the year. One more.
Now make it for now. Here's the clear. You got a shade over here. Let him know. And of course, the defense comes a little bit late. The foul occurs, but you've got to play on his right hand in that case because it's an open side.
Successful trip for Jerron Brown. Lead back to 9. 8:35 to go in this second round encounter at the Fleet Center in Boston before another sellout crowd. We have had wonderful crowds in the Fleet Center for both first and second round games.
Well, they saved the double. Now, Sabatis gets back. Pretty move. Everything but there by Newton. He's looking for the foul.
Pretty good defense from Troutman, I
sure was. Chesty.
There's the screen from Troutman. Brandon Knight brings it back outside. Jerron Brown leads it for Brandon Knight.
They don't take bad shots. Everybody understands. I mean, that's what makes them so tough each evening.
Pittsburgh team is Knight.
We got a timeout. Ben didn't like what he saw. Brown and Moyer banging chests.
Time call.
Why do I rent from Enterprise? For more cargo room. More people room. Or more headroom. Enterprise. So easy, it's like having a second car. Or third.
Pick Enterprise. We'll pick you up.
It's far better to spend 15 seconds looking at this now than in 15 years wishing you had. Retirement. Loans. Insurance. AIG. We know money.
I take good care of the lawn, I do. Do you bag or mulch?
Man, this party needs help. Better music. Hey now,
you're an all-star. I'm a mulcher.
A better host.
So, guy goes into a bar.
And a better chip that doesn't break. Introducing new Tostitos Gold, a whole new kind of Tostitos made extra thick for hearty dips with an authentic Mexican taste. New Tostitos Gold, the perfect chip for hearty dips.
Bag?
I mulch.
All together and safe, so competitive. Brothers to the core, we late, don't forget it. In bad times and good, friend or foe. If life's a game you play, then I'm one for all. All day in the dirt, my sweat's my paycheck. We're brothers to the core. It's like one for all, if one should fall. We tight despite the weather and fight for one cause. We're brothers to the core, so please believe me. Never forfeit the game, my team needs me. No one ever said success would come easy. But that's when my friends step in with L-O-V-E.
Purchase 20 tons of steel for the factory in Milan.
Piece of cake, next.
Buy 300 hydraulic assemblies for the Washington factory by Friday.
Done.
Ooh, best price on titanium discs in Singapore.
Look at this, four partners ready to bid.
As you bore me.
You guys got any light bulbs?
How many pallets?
Domestic or international?
No, just one.
I can't do one.
He can't do one.
.NET Connected Software helps you connect with partners. That's software for the agile business. From Microsoft.
And now let's take a look at our Microsoft Agile move of the game. Bill?
Well, not too bad. Has slipped to the goal. Troutman able to finish, but Brandon Knight igniting the offense. Great defensive plays consistently, but Bern Lundquist, as you finish the homework there.
Microsoft Agile move of the game. Brandon Knight, the senior from East Orange, New Jersey.
and Indiana within hailing distance, though. I mean, it's amazing.
Yeah, they've hung around. They sure have.
2-3 zone after the timeout, under 10 seconds on the shot clock.
Marshall Strickland back on the floor now with Coverdale. There's Knight. And Bracy Wright cleans it.
Yeah, 3 seconds left on the clock. Really didn't get much out of it. Nice move by Mike Davis going to the zone, though. Threw him off a little bit.
There's Wright. George Leach and Coverdale, and there is Julius Page. Double comes on Newton. He kicks it left side. Touch pass into Leach. Knight back to harass him.
And he got it. Good job, man. That's,
yes.
They really handled the double beautifully. Nothing much Newton could do. The kick out and then the dump down to Big Leach.
Very effective game for George Leach. He's got 12 on 6 of 9 shooting in the ballgame.
Give the zone another run here. In the middle, George Leach can block shots. Oh, he didn't stay with it, but what a great block. The flash to the mid-post and a steal in the backcourt by Julius Page. He's got some blood. They're going to have to take him out, I think.
Yep. Cut lip as he made the steal.
And it's unusual. It's usually Pitt that gets other people to cut their lip. Oh, hustle continues on the defensive end by Pittsburgh.
Introduce yourself to Bacardi Silver 03 Premium Malt Beverage. As much fun as you can have with orange. 5% alcohol by volume. Your night just got more interesting.
Using HP mobile technology to get information quickly and easily, the world's police forces now fight crime digitally.
When I get older, losing my hair many years from now, will you still be sending me a Valentine? Birthday greetings, bottle of wine. If I'd been out till 2:45, would you lock the door? Will you still need me? Will you still feed me when I'm 64?
The Chevy Trailblazer worst-case scenario. What to do if tailgated by a giant overhauler? Don't slow down or pull one of those I'm braking slightly to freak you out stunts. You won't like the results. Simply let that standard 275-horsepower Vortec engine send a clear message. Get off my rear, poor man. Here you have a best-case scenario. Chevy Trailblazer. Like a rock.
Excuse me, do you know what investments are in your retirement account?
Okay. No.
And how about you folks?
We have no idea.
And how about your retirement account?
I just adjusted it. Now I'm 50% stocks, 30% bonds, 20% cash.
You can stay close to your money with online tools from TD Waterhouse. Do your own homework. Plan your own future. You can't plan for tomorrow if you don't know where your money is today.
TD Waterhouse. You're in control.
Well, Vern Lundquist, take the Chevy to the levee, and this levee is not dry. How about that flash to bounce pass to finish him? Where, George, keep going after him. Now he takes the ball out, falls asleep. He should have blocked the shot. Now he falls asleep. When he inbounds, you got to concentrate. And Page comes up with a stiff upper lip as they took the timeout to get him organized, make sure there was no blood on the uniform.
Jerron Brown will inbound right in front of us and gets it in the hands of Brandon Knight. 6:46 to go in the ballgame. And Pitt leading 52-43, going after their 28th victory against 4 defeats for the year.
This little staggered double to get the open look. Page out of a timeout.
Yes.
They are well organized, well oiled. Benjamin has got them purring.
Largest lead of the ballgame. First time they've been to 12.
Now the key is they force them to use a lot of time. You can see the trends in the game right there. Boy, that's a tough little release, huh? How about George Leach? Big game. He's got to do it at this end now.
He's had some mental lapses in this game, but he's 7-10 offensively for a total of 14 points. Now Newton out on Siobhan Troutman.
Watch the screen now for Knight. Eventually, Knight he got knocked down. Troutman's looking at the screen for it. It's a nice little set play they run to get him on track.
Here's Jerron Brown, strong runner, good.
Yep. UConn may be the best team in the country for unusual mid-range shots. They practice them all the time. Jerron Brown would fit right in. But he is incredible at making those difficult angles, difficult distance releases. And look at that. That's good defense. And Ontario can't believe it, but Wisely keeps the lip buttoned. Just the use of screens, so incredible. Get Page on into the game. And here's the shot we were just talking about, Vern. That is tough. You got traffic. You got no. You can't look off the glass on that particular shot. It's a dead-end shot.
Ontario, that picks up his third. Leach at the free throw line, shoots one more. Well, a very quiet, relatively quiet, 6 of 7 for Jerron Brown.
And this is a team you overlook all the parts.
Right.
But the whole, you can't overlook. Each guy's got something he can do.
Remember what Jim Calhoun said about this Pittsburgh team? We did UConn Pitt at Pitt. He said, I don't think they're the best. But they don't have the most talent in the league, but they're the best team in the league.
And Ben initially thought it was disparaging.
Yes, he bristled a little bit.
Because, you know, you don't want anything negative said. And he said, we got to have some talent. Look what we've done in this league.
Right.
But the idea is they conceptually put it all together to win. They're not into individual exploits.
There's Brandon Knight. There's the switch. Now the switch back. Entry pass. Troutman. Leach.
Might be Strickland, too. Okay. He's down there helping out.
See who they got. Yep, Strickland.
Where the ball is getting inside easily, and that's a detriment to the morale as well as guys being able to finish.
Troutman goes to the line for Pitt. 13 of 20 as a team in this game.
What was Ben's line on him? The best sixth man in the country?
Yeah, he thinks he is the best sixth man, best non-starter in the country, mm-hmm. Siobhan Troutman.
You mentioned Ben and those West Coast ties. He's really fitting nicely recruiting. And of course, everybody's mentioning him amongst others. And he's just at UCLA. He's right. Just all about his business at Pitt. Feels very comfortable. And they've recruited well, too. So this is going to continue.
Ben Howland came from Northern Arizona 4 years ago. Here's Coverdale. Entry pass. Nice. Hornsby for three.
They run out, but they don't give up on it. You don't give an uncontested shot if you're playing for Pitt. Brandon Knight up on him.
Well, opportunities coming up short now, and the Pittsburgh faithful behind the Pitt bench stand and urge their team on.
Well, Pitt massages you to sleep, puts you in submission. You don't even know the lights are out. How about that finish?
Well, flick the switch.
He is terrific around the rim. Jerron Brown.
18 points on 7 of 8.
And Coverdale finally gets a look. I mean, without anybody on him, he's been wearing white all game. They're not a great pressing team either. That's one of the dilemmas. And Pitt's never in a hurry.
Well, they will wind this clock down as far as they can on this possession. Here's Julius Page.
Until that. Send it in.
Then when the opportunity is there, you've got to take advantage of it.
Amazing. And the breakdown defensively because they're trying to press on the perimeter.
Knight out defensively. Let's see if Pitt chooses to run. They do not.
What a close by Julius Page. You better play both ends for Ben Howland.
Foul on Coverdale. That's 4 on the senior from Noblesville, Indiana. Such a presence in the marvelous run to the Final Four for Indiana last year. made a million memories for himself and for Indiana fans, did Tom Coverdale. Now Brandon Knight like to ignite that same kind of a run for Pitt. Tell you, I think they can get there.
Well, defensively, I mean, that's the key. We all know that because you can have dry spells and guys aren't shooting well, and the understated Mel and everyone. If you talk basketball, Brenda, she would embarrass both of us. She's been that game.
Really?
You know, with the two balls, she really gets into it, understands it. Of course, Mel just always under control. But along the way to the NCAA, Brenda wants to go. Pitt wants to go. You do it page by page, word by word. Send it in, JP.
Very funny.
What?
For that long road to maturity, we'll be there.
This pancake, it looks just like Mom. You gotta see this.
Now we can. PCS Vision from Sprint, you could do more. Like take, send, and receive full-color pictures right on your phone on the largest enhanced nationwide PCS network.
You see, doesn't it look like her? Thanks.
You're welcome. Bon appetit.
I can't.
PCS Vision from Sprint. Clearly a whole new way to look at wireless.
Michelin designed the cross-terrain SUV tires specifically for SUVs to help provide responsive handling and a smooth ride. You'd be surprised just how smooth. Michelin, because so much is riding on your tires.
Why do I rent from Enterprise? Because having the right car or truck makes all the difference. Sweetheart, your honey-do list just got a little bit longer. Sorry.
Pick Enterprise. We'll pick you up.
The Home Depot is more than a store. It's a classroom where the know-how is free and the homework is fun. It's how to build something or paint something or plant something. The place that can take you from wondering how to knowing how. And the guaranteed low price every day to make every dollar work. The Home Depot. You can do it. We can help.
Well, the Panther is taking a dive. Pitt by 16. It's about knockout time. And coming up, Butler against Louisville. Here in Boston, you'll see Oklahoma State against Syracuse. That means Eddie Sutton and Jim Boeheim, two of the best coaches ever. 65-49, 3:24 to go. Tom Coverdale to Jeff Newton. They might be 3.5 minutes away from their final shot of their collegiate careers.
This is where they got to get it. This is where they got to get it, though, Vern. Newton can make the three. That's what's impressive about him. But they got to get something off the defense. They get a foul or a timeout?
Timeout, I believe. Yeah. Yes. 65-52.
Well, the girls have been sharing a wireless phone.
Yeah, I can help you out here.
At Sprint stores, buy one A460 Samsung phone and get a second one free. Plus, get 500 anytime minutes to share for $65 a month with unlimited night, weekend, and PCS to PCS calling. PCS from Sprint, clearly a whole new way to look at wireless.
13-point Pitt lead, 3:05 remaining in this second-round game from Boston. Let's check the CBS Sportsline stat of the game. Rebounding edge for Pittsburgh, 24-16. Get complete game stats at CBSSportsline.com or on America Online. Enter keyword CBS
Sports Live.
And Pitt out-rebounds the opponent by almost seven a game, plus seven. That's an impressive number.
Keeps you in the win column.
Jerron Brown will send it in to Siobhan Troutman. Knight, Brown, Brandon Knight's going to go to the line as Bracy Wright fouls him.
And then Mike Davis wants the correct guy to be fouled. And the reason he's mad at Hornsby is if they don't want Hornsby to foul, who almost fouled because that would have been the limit.
Yeah.
I was wondering what Mike was up after him.
Now Hornsby's got four. Here's Brandon Knight. Five of seven for the day. Well, Notre Dame in the Sweet 16 for the first time 16 years. Duke, six in a row. Five overtime games and a couple of buzzer beaters. It's been a splendid weekend.
Incredible. Chris Ente with the great outside shooting. Keeps you glued to the TV set
the end of these games.
Keeps you from sitting down to dinner, doesn't it?
It does. Quite a bit. And I was not upset about that at all.
No, I know that. We waited on the beefsteak until we saw Gonzaga, Arizona last night. At the other end is Paige. Quick pass. Beautiful.
Did they play together? Heady play, touch pass.
Oh, totally unselfish. Here's Wright.
Tough with a guy on you that you don't get the legs under it. Wright up and challenging the shot. Pretty basketball. When you're unselfish, the spirit grows. And nice little touch pass. And you notice George Lee's really couldn't detect the play. He thought the ball was going to come down in Page's hands. He just runs through. Terrific run out. They take advantage of those opportunity breaks.
There's Julius Page on Coverdale again. 15 Indiana turnovers.
I'll tell you, Julius Page is a nightmare defensively. I mean, he just rags his guy, always in touch. Maybe two mistakes in the first half on jump shots.
Right.
Came a little late. They're just going to foul Brandon, and he loves it.
2:21 remaining, and the lead is 17. Brandon Knight has missed only two today. He's going to go back to the free throw line.
This is great practice for him.
Yes, it is.
You know, in a tight game, he knows, and he respects people. That he understands the deal. You know, he's going to have to make them and prove that he's going to make them.
6 of 8 at the line today. 6 of 9. And the Chevrolet most valuable players of the game today, George Leach, 15 points, Julius Page, 13 points, but we gave it to him for his defensive effort on Tom Coverdale. Tom Coverdale, the senior who had 23 the other night and 20 the game before that, is 2 of 6 for 6 points in his last game.
And the six is what's incredible. He can't get a look. You saw there, he thought he had one. Page all over. Look at this read by Knight.
There's Brandon Knight, Coverdale back. Just makes a pass at him.
Smooth.
And a nice decision by Coverdale.
Sure was. He's a tough guy. We all know that, Tom Coverdale. But with that, look at this shot he's forced to take. I mean, that's amazing. And at this stage of the game, you can't fault him at all. Reality's starting to set in. The head's bowing a little bit. The Pitt faithful. Boy, they are aroused in the city. They love their Panthers.
Well, they've got that marvelous new Peterson Event Center on campus. Seats 12,500. It is just a magnificent place in which to watch a basketball game. And Pitt's going to advance to the Sweet 16 for the second year in a row. Hopefully for them, they get farther than they did a year ago when they lost to Kent State. And the clock showing 90 seconds to go.
Zabakis is a treat, though. The facial expression. Look at this.
How about that?
You'd be out for a year if you caught that in the midsection.
I would be singing alto, I'll guarantee you.
Oh, was that something? And Trauman, unabashed, just caught it. It went to the rim. It was not intended for him. That was a enduring fastball.
It was supposed to go to Jerron Brown, and Troutman caught it and raised his voice 3 octaves.
Ouch. That was punishing.
Well, the final game for Tom Coverdale, Kyle Hornsby, Jeff Newton. What marvelous careers the three seniors have had for the Hoosiers of Indiana.
The Home Depot is more than a store. It's a powerhouse with powerful names and tools for mowing, blowing, edging, or just riding with the wind. It's the guaranteed low price. And right now, it's no payments or interest until January 2004 when you make any John Deere tractor, Toro, or Honda mower purchase of $299 or more with your Home Depot credit card. It's the power to turn the outdoors into the great outdoors. The Home Depot. You can do it. We can help.
Mike Davis is going to bring Jeff Newton to the bench. He's going to bring Tom Coverdale to the bench.
That's great.
Kyle Hornsby to the bench. He salutes and embraces each.
That is wonderful.
John Treloar.
Jim Thomas there. And Larry Conley looking on in the background there. I mean, this is just, look at the tears. That's wonderful. Ben McDonald alongside as well. I mean, they have really worked hard. Great kids. They had so many other games. They had 11 Indiana games last year.
Wow.
This is 8 this year. He won so many things, I can't remember them. Three straight years in the 20s. First Indiana coach to do that.
And a typical Pittsburgh game as they are on defense now. Mike Roberts is out on the floor. This ball tipped by McCarroll. Look at the guard, the point guard, between the legs. See, it isn't so big. Oh, over and back.
He's smiling.
74-52. Pittsburgh advances to the round of 16. And they will take on Marquette. It'll be a 2-3 in the Midwest round. And Donald Perry is going to dribble this one out. Pittsburgh. Brown has 20. Knight has 17. Page has 13. Troutman has 10. And Lett has 9. Just a typical Pittsburgh game. Pitt ends with a 24-9 run. In the last 7 minutes, coming up next, 12-seeded Butler against 4-seeded Louisville in one game with a tip time of 2:20. And back here in Boston, we'll have Oklahoma State and Syracuse with an approximate tip time of 2:40. Pittsburgh wins it. Big. They go to 28-4 for the year.